I'm sitting in a forest that I just wrote, and I was sitting in a forest and I just spent an hour and 15 minutes writing music and then practicing scales. There's a lot of good that comes from being in a forest, and I think that a lot of people, writers like Henry David Thoreau, as well as a lot of other people who are more in touch with the old world, think that people have become very disconnected from nature, and there are subconscious elements of that that make them unhappy as a result of that. And if you go back maybe 100 years, 200 years, people lived in the wilderness, and then cities came as man-made constructs. And I value city life for many reasons. There's a lot of arts that proliferate there, the dynamicism, speed of life. You really get to experience, you grow a lot, you know a deeper variety of people, and all that's there. Those are benefits of city life. And I grew up near New York, and so I was privy to all those things. There's something about nature and forest life as well that's, I think, very important to the human spirit. And I wrote some good stuff. We've got a song called Some Things Are Made in Heaven, or Made in Heaven, me and my band. That's the working name, at least, and it's about how when you come to Earth, all the beautiful things that you can see when you're on Earth, and it's about taking someone on a tour, sort of like one of those old Christmas movies where you have not the Grinch, but some fairy comes and takes someone around through their whole life and shows how happy everything is. Maybe It's a Wonderful Life, one of those old movies. Although, of course, the concept wasn't inspired by that, but it's something similar to that. Someone coming onto Earth and then through this music, seeing all the beautiful stuff, the animals, the people, the cities, the nature, and it's talking about how beautiful the world is. And I think that a lot of people have lost sight of how beautiful things are, maybe because they don't spend enough time in nature, or maybe because they're very wrapped up within their own lives and their own problems. So, we have another song called Days Go By, which is about how the span of people's life, it goes by. And no matter how much you exercise, no matter how much time you put into preserving your health, within time, it'll just take more time. People's bodies age and decline, then eventually they die, and it happens to all of us. I have a friend who recently posted on Facebook a photo of himself looking old, and he says, "When did I become this old?" And he started comparing himself to a grandpa, and he showed a photo of himself from the 1980s where he looked a lot younger. And people don't realize how fast things go by, which is why it's so important to, as they say in Dead Poets Society, carpe diem, seize the day. You live this day once, you live this moment once. Live it as you best see fit. Rid and eliminate yourself of as many faults and problems as quickly as you can, in order to make sure that every living moment you have is as good as it can be. Living in peace with the people around you, with the environment around you, within your own self, to be able to act and operate with strength when necessary. And of course, through that process of ridding yourself of faults and blind spots, there's a pain element, and that's a good pain. There's two types of pain. There's bad pain, which is based on doing things the wrong way. Like, for example, if there's a wall that you're trying to break and you just keep on punching at it over and over and over, that's going to give pain to your hand. If there's a dead horse that you keep beating, that's the sort of pain that is useless and is because you're doing something incorrectly. Then there's the productive type of pain, which comes when you are undergoing something that is beyond your current range. For example, if you can't touch your toes and you're stretching a little bit further than you were before, there's an element of discomfort. I mean, with stretching, if you're in pain, you're gonna tear something, so don't have pain there. But the type of pain that comes when you push a little bit harder in a workout, when your mind is telling you to stop, but you keep on going, the type of pain that when you're forced to think about something or consider someone's perspective that you didn't think about before, which is threatening to your own perspective, but which you need to consider because you two people are at odds and somehow need to find a way to make things work out. Those are the productive types of pain. And those are the types of pain that are worth undergoing in order to, for your own betterment and the betterment of the society and species around you. I've written in many text messages to many friends that the minute that people stop avoiding pain is the minute that society fundamentally transforms. And when I say transform, I mean the negative elements of them eroding out. The negative elements, such as addictions to substances, such as not liking other, such as not liking other people, the negative elements such as addiction to substances, hatred, anger, what have you. All these things are based on excessive self-preservation, and the you can talk to a psychologist about how the mechanisms in your brain between pain and pleasure work on the same two sides of the same coin, and they're both based in an evolutionary self-preservation. We like sugar because it gives us energy, which makes us feel that we have more, we can do more. It's something like that. I don't know exactly the mechanism of sugar, but all of these negative things that we get addicted on are based in survival instinct. Bears eat a lot so that they can hibernate through winter and literally survive, and then wake up in the spring and hoard food again. People have the same mechanism where they eat a lot in order to feel a sense of safety or comfort, and they feel an element of pain when they stop doing that. I just talked to a friend who lost like 20 pounds over a few months, not by exercising, but just by eating less. And and the pain that he experienced through that is a type of productive pain. It's the pain that when you're doing it, it feels bad, but you know that it's good. Some deeper part of you knows that this is a good pain. This is the pain that makes you stronger. And who doesn't want to be a strong person? I know I want to be one, and I know if I want to be one, I know everyone wants to be one. So, because we all operate relatively similarly, we all want essentially the same feelings, although it'll take different forms. I want to be a great tennis player, I want to be a singer, you know, a lot of people have no interest in that, but they want to do well in their career, whatever it may be, and they want to look upon themselves with self-respect, and they want to live in peaceful environments with the people around them. These are some of the commonalities that we all have because we're all human. And the ways in which we find those things often align along the same principles. For me, it may be running harder or running to a tennis shot that I wouldn't have run to before, and therefore making myself believe that I can do more. Whereas for someone else, it might be asking for a promotion that they wouldn't have asked for otherwise, or talking to somebody that they wouldn't have talked to, or cooking their food with more spice, more experimentally, or my acting teacher, Marco, directing a play that he was scared to direct. The forms are different, but the underlying emotions are the same. Something you thought you couldn't do, you then go and do, and then through the process you experience some fear, some pain, you go through all of it, and then at the end of the day you've done something, you've succeeded, you've bettered yourself, and you can live more in alignment with the people around you because you've gotten rid of weakness within yourself. So to put that simply into one sentence, don't avoid pain, the natural pain, and jump into the pain that is the productive pain, the good pain, the pain that you know is good. When that happens, the amount of things you can do drastically increase, but more importantly, the amount of self-preservation, which doesn't feel good, the amount of self-preservation you feel drops. The amount of close-offness you have towards other people drops. The less, like if you're a smoker, a lot of smokers need to plan their you know, they might be less inclined to take a very long flight if they're trying to go to Europe or Asia, because that's going to be 10 hours with which they can't have a cigarette. They might take a layover, right? I mean, it's that type of thinking. They go to an amusement park and they chart where the smoking sections are so that they can smoke, right? That doesn't actually feel good. You don't want to have to do that. You don't want to have to start planning and plotting when you're going to get your next fix instead of actually being in the moment and enjoying what it is you're doing. So, but of course the smoker is going to feel an element of pain when they start feeling withdrawal symptoms, or psychological symptoms first and then physical withdrawal symptoms, and so much as that pain is there within them, that pain is always there dormantly, and it just finds an opportunity to surface. And that's why in a larger sense, irrespective of smoking, when you're doing things in regular life, when pain arises within you, within the context of relationships, fear within, you know, career, fear within a personal endeavor, whatever it may be, fear of talking to somebody, use that as an opportunity to look inwards at pain or fear that you're feeling within yourself. It's not necessarily inherent to the situation. It's definitely there within you. Another person might look at the same situation, and because they don't fear that particular thing, just ask for the promotion or go talk to that person or take this risk, which to you may feel like a risk, which to them doesn't. Or maybe it feels like a risk to them, but they do it anyway because they've conditioned themselves to be able to do so. So being open to the fact that there are many, many, many more things out there than the things that you feel currently, that your life can change when you are able to embrace pain, that actually opens up a world much larger than anything I can describe to you, and your life can fundamentally change when you stop focusing so much on self-preservation. You can enjoy things more profoundly. You can sit in a forest and not worry about what's coming next, not worry about are the lyrics that I'm writing good, because you're just writing, right? Then you can worry about it later. But you can perceive somebody without thinking about the storyline of what they've done to you, good or bad, what your history with them is, and just engage with them in the present moment as they are at that moment. The whole world opens up. Again, like I've listed just a few of the many, many aspects of life that open up when you're able to stop avoiding pain, stop focusing on self-preservation, stop focusing excessively on your own self, and actually just live and engage. And sure as our song Days Go By says it, days go by, and you want to make sure the days go by are good, because eventually you're going to grow older and older and older. It happens. I'm 26. I see photos of myself when I was 7. I don't remember any definitive moment that I transformed from 7 to 26. It was a series of moments that occurred, which are irreversible at this point, as will it be for the rest of the time that I age. So I want to make sure those days are good. I want to enjoy and experience life profoundly. And a lot of the things that I worried about when I was a teenager and in my early 20s and even probably yesterday were a bunch of nonsense. Some of it was valid, but almost all of it was just garbage. And it made me very unhappy. How much better would my life have been then, and how much more carryover of good feelings would I have now if I never worried about stuff that was meaningless? You see, that was based on self-preservation. So days go by. Days go by. And I want to make sure those days are good. Don't avoid pain.